we have NAIA first round action here on the campus of Montana Tech. The place is loud. Coach Adam Hyatt, first off, congratulations. Huge conference victory. Winning the conference for the third time, winning the tournament for the third time. Talk about what preparation has been like here over the last couple weeks.
Well, boy, it's been a long time since we played. It's been a couple weeks. You know, our guys are going a little bit stir crazy. They just want to play so bad. I mean, we've been playing really well this year, and then now all of a sudden it's like we got a week off. Well, that didn't work out very well.
We're live, guys.
Watch out, sir. All right, let's continue that thread as far as the couple weeks off. I mean, there's advantages to that, but also it has to be tough to kind of temper expectations.
Yeah, no, it is. I mean, we tried to be really smart with our time last week. And we just didn't want to go too hard, but we wanted to stay competitive at the same time. And once we found out the bracket, then we really got into our preparation. But it's an honor to be here. We told the guys before the game we've earned the right to be able to host by nature of having a great season. But we haven't been entitled to anything. We have to earn the right to advance in this tournament. We're going to have our hands full today.
And this Wayland Baptist team, very physical. They're going to get after you a little bit. What are their keys, in your opinion, that they're going to bring at you?
Well, they got a couple guards that are really dynamic. They got three guys that can really shoot the three, and they have a big kid that's just a load inside. You know, we got to do a great job of protecting the paint, and we got to keep guys off the three-point line. But more importantly, their ability to run out and transition. The league that they play in, the Sooner Athletic Conference, is a tremendous athletic league. They got guys that are really fast, speed up and down the floor. You know, so we got to be able to get back and build a wall and keep them out of the paint and transition. I think if we do that, we're going to have success.
Coach Adam Hyatt, thank you, and let's roll. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll take a break. We have more in the pregame coming up.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then AIM Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Starts playing inside through our big DeMichael Bell build. He's been huge for us, especially the second semester. And so just kind of playing through him and kind of playing inside out. And then, also on the other end, on the defensive side, we really started guard, you know, the last month of the year.
The one word I keep hearing a lot, and it feels like that's our word of this tournament, is defense. And you guys are very tenacious. You're going to get after it. And it feels like that's going to kind of be, honestly, the thread that we're going to see here tonight between two very good defensive teams.
Absolutely. Montana Tech, you know, you look at their numbers, really, really good defensive team. And so it's going to see kind of who can do what they do better, you know? So.
Has the trip been okay? Everything going all right?
It's long trip, but a little different than West Texas, so it's nice to see some mountains and some scenery.
Well, Coach, I won't keep you any longer. Thanks for your time. Best of luck. We look forward to what should be a great game.
Hey, appreciate it. Thank you.
Coach Gallion, ladies and gentlemen, here at Wayland Baptist. We'll take a break. We'll give you some numbers and more right after this.
Dave Brennan here with Case IH. One of the new options for model year 2024 is going to be an open spoke gauge wheel. That open spoke gauge wheel is going to be available on all 2000 series planters. That's going to help those growers in adverse conditions, whether they're muddy or high residue conditions, minimize that plugging in and around that gauge wheel area. For more information on this new offering of open spoke gauge wheels, visit your local Case IH dealer.
Hey, welcome back here once again as we get ready for game two, first round of the NAIA National Tournament. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher, Montana Tech taking on the Pioneers of Wayland Baptist University. It's been a great day here in the Mining City. We had a fantastic game to get us underway. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State knocking off Hope International, and the Warriors are into round two. We'll find out who their opponent's going to be here after we get to the end of a couple hours.
Yeah, pretty shortly there's a bunch of teams going home. One game, this is a big one, and you cut into me right when I'm eating my hot dog. That is not right.
Paul Panisco, John Thatcher, of course, who is always eating a hot dog, ladies and gentlemen. But this place is filling up. We have a packed house, and this is going to be fun. You know, this is another one, Coach and I were talking about, Coach Galleon and I, the threat on this thing, as far as this tournament feels, defense. You know, everybody out of these four teams feel like they're really built on defense. We saw that in the first two teams, and we're certainly going to see that here. This Wayland Baptist team is going to get after you. They have a very powerful post, real strong on the interior. They have fantastic guards, but they bring good defensive pressure. And then on the other side, Montana Tech, one of the best defensive teams in the country. They've given up 65 points a game, which is fifth in the nation. They don't give the ball up. They get turnovers, and they just wear you down on the defensive side.
They do wear you down, and the reality of this team is they take care of the basketball so well they don't get in trouble, and that's why they've had so many blowouts this season. They put enough pressure on the other team, force turnovers, and there's a couple games we had where they had 3, 4, or 5 turnovers. That's magnificent when your team can take care of the basketball like that.
Well, again, thanks for joining us. This Montana Tech team, Frontier Conference champion, regular season champions, the Frontier Conference tournament champions, the third year in a row for both of those. The Digs finished the season 26-4. They're 14-1 in the Frontier Conference. On the other side, Wayland Baptist coming out of the Sooner Athletic Conference. They finished, they're an at-large bid here into the tournament. They're 21-9 overall, 15-7 in the Sooner Athletic Conference. And they certainly bring incredible athleticism. And a much different look than I think we are used to coming into this ball game here tonight from the Montana Tech perspective.
Well, they're talented, no question about it. But I got one question. Did they fly here or did they take a bus here?
You know, that's a great question because I brought it up to Coach and he said it was a long trip.
So they took the bus. Yeah. That is a long trip, by the way.
Yeah, that is very, very long.
That has an effect on you.
Well, let's talk about that. If they did bus up here, on top of that, we're now talking about a very significant altitude change as well. A couple factors that could play against the Pioneers here tonight.
Absolutely, they can play against them. And that bus ride is a killer. I took a bus once from here to Spokane, and I was worn out by the time I got there, and that's only a 4-hour or 5-hour drive. So I can't imagine coming all the way up here from Texas and in a bus. Not fun.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. Hopefully everything going well as the Digs getting ready to take on Wayland Baptist. Let's take a quick break. We'll come back and we'll run you through the starters. We'll talk about important players and a little bit more about both these teams right after this.
TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steel's Furniture, making man caves happen for 87 years.
Hey, once again, welcome here to the campus of Montana Tech. This joint is packed, and
And we had a little tailgate action earlier. There were pork chops thrown around, and life as we know it is good.
For these students, it is. They got to be happy.
I am here to tell you, and actually, I'm glad you bring up the students. Are, you know, with the NAIA tournament, we can't allow students in. We have to charge, you know, tickets for playoff games. And the Montana Tech Foundation, along with Dick City, sponsored our student tickets. So the students got free tickets if they went up, showed their student ID. So our thanks to the Montana Tech Foundation and Dick City. I see John Wick over there. The handsome young man he is, we thank both of them for making it possible for our students to get in without having to pay a dime.
That is awesome, because without the students, you don't even need to be in this gym. It's all about them.
That's the deal. So let's take a look at this. Wayland Baptist, the Pioneers, coming to town 21-9 on the year, 15-7 out of the Sooner Athletic Conference. Their guards are phenomenal. I mean, these guys, probably a level of quickness we don't have in the Frontier Conference, to be completely honest. As Taji Hill is the man, a 6'3" junior, tremendous guard, transfer out of Temple. He wears number zero, averages 13 points a game. You see the starters up there. We'll go through them a little bit here and again. But Taji Hill is just having himself a season for this Wayland Baptist team. And it's he is going to be public enemy number one, as well as down in the block in Belfield. You see Belfield there, Michael Belfield in the block. He's a 6'9" senior. He's a monster. Wears number 50, gets 13 points a game.
Well, the game's all about guards. I don't care. Guards need to score. Guards need to create. Guards need to do a lot of things. The big's great to have, but the reality is Montana Tech's got a couple quick guards too, so it's going to be a great matchup to see this quickness versus quickness.
You know, and I always love the idea of ones against ones is great, but when you start to get into that depth, where's the drop-off? You know, what is your drop-off at point guard from year one to year two? What is the drop-off?
On Montana Tech's team, there is none.
Exactly. And that's kind of what I was getting
yes.
at. You know, whether it's in the block, whether it's shooting guard, whatever it is, you know, your number ones are always going to be exceptional. But it's that interesting when things really start to get heavy, when, you know, you got guys breathing hard, you know, they're really gassed. When those next guys come on the floor, the separation there is really going to be a big factor in a huge game like this here tonight.
Absolutely it is. And you and I both know their backup guard takes backup guard, maybe my favorite player on the Tech team. In fact, two or three players off their bench are my favorite players, because they're the only team in the Frontier Conference that I thought could go five or six deep and at the same time not hurt them a bit. I thought these five guys could start somewhere else in the Frontier Conference. That's how good they are. So he's got five great starters and five great guys off the bench.
How many games have we played this year where Montana Tech has scored 9 or 10 deep, and it's not, you know, guys scoring in garbage time. It's guys scoring in the first half where you get a guards coming in, you get backup threes coming in. You know, the idea of, like you say, going 9, 10 deep, and they have done it all year long.
Yeah, well, one of the things we're going to watch out here for today is they've got to go on an early run. And you know, you get excited when you got a team that can score like this, and the reality is it starts with the first basket. You don't want to get way ahead of yourself expecting a blowout. So probably going to have a tight first half here, competitive first half. But I think they really shine after halftime.
Well, again, this Wayland Baptist team coming out of the Sooner Athletic Conference, really kind of led by defense as well. You know, they come in here out-rebounding teams by about 8 rebounds a game, which is a huge margin. That's something that is going to be addressed here today, as that's a big separation in the number of rebounds pulled down.
Well, it's interesting you say that, because I felt the key to this game was, one, taking care of the basketball, which, you know me like a book, that's the first thing I think of. Secondly, is control of the boards.
You know, the other one that I'm real interested to see what's going to happen is one of those numbers that has to give. This Wayland Baptist team comes in averaging about 82 points a game. Montana Tech's defense gives up about 65 a game. And that's going to be real interesting to see which one we're closer to in that by the end of this 40 minutes.
You want to see a game of runs? You're going to look at one right now here today.
Do you think that's the game? You think game's going to be won by runs?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Interesting.
Absolutely.
Interesting. Montana Tech getting ready to take on Wayland Baptist, ladies and gentlemen. First round of the NAIA National Tournament as the Digs come in, the number 8 team in the country. Wayland Baptist, an at-large bid, and again, they're another program that certainly has been to the dance a lot. They certainly know their way around this national tournament, and they are going to be ready to roll here today. Montana Tech taking on Wayland Baptist. Let's take a quick timeout. We'll come back. We'll get you the starters. We'll get this thing rolling right after this.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. As you see the graphic on the screen there, Montana Tech, the number 3 seed out of the Naismith quadrant. And Wayland comes in the number 14 team on this side of the bracket. And we're getting ready for what should be a great one. Montana Tech, Wayland Baptist, the Digs taking on the Pioneers. For the Pioneers early, JT, what's important for them to get established in the first 5 minutes?
Well, they can't give up offensive boards to Tech, and Mr. Asia has to be guarded. This guy has been on fire the last couple months, and he's the guy you got to stop on this team. You know, I've always had a philosophy. Scorers are going to score, but you got to stop everybody else. So maybe that's the key to this thing. But I think rebounds are real, real important thing. And then how are the runs divided? I think that's going to be an important part.
On the other side for Montana Tech, what do they want to get set in stone early?
I think they have got to. I think we got to push the ball. I think they got to. Yeah, they do, but they don't. They like to run their stuff, and they're good at it. I think defensively, they got to stop this team from pushing the ball.
Okay.
Defense will be real key.
All right. Well, let's do this. We're going to get our starting lineup, so we'll get our crew. Barrett and company will get the starters on the screen. We'll talk about them one more time here as Montana Tech getting ready to take on Wayland Baptist. There are the Pioneer starters. They finished fourth in the Sooner Athletic Conference. They fell to Langston in the semis in a really good ball game. I'm telling you, this Pioneers team has played awfully well this year. You'll see their starting five there. Brett Leach is on the floor. He's averaging 10 a game. Belfield down in the block to Michael Belfield, 13 points a game, the 6'9" senior. Murray is incredibly athletic. Looks like Murray, a 6'6" junior, averages 12 points a game. Tajah Hill averages 13. He's a 6'3" junior, wears number 0. And Quentin Coleman is also starting. Coleman is actually their leading scorer, the 5'10" junior. He wears number 11. He averages 14 a game for the Pioneers out of Wayland Baptist.
Yep, they got size, 6'9". That's a tough matchup for Montana Tech. I want to see the physicality of him versus Michael Ure. That'll be an interesting matchup itself.
And then the other side of that Michael Ure matchup is if they're able to come out and guard the perimeter against Michael Ure, as Ure shoots nearly 40% from the three-point line, but he can't get you going to the rim as well.
Well, he can, and you know, that's the key to post up. That's the key to, if you've got a post player that can post up and then come out and shoot the three, most post players are not used to guarding the perimeter.
Well, let's take a look at the Montana Tech side. This place is loud. The starting five coming out on the floor here for Montana Tech. We have a packed house. Aza Williams is first out for the Digs. Aza, 6'6" senior out of Ohio. Aza averages 16 a game. First team all conference for the Frontier Conference. Krishan Dixon, a 6-foot senior, wears number 3 out of Billings, Montana. He'll run the point for the Digs to get this one started. Next out, Caleb Billich. Billich, Frontier Conference MVP a blew his knee in the first game last year of the national tournament. He has fought his way back. He's averaging 13 a game. He's a first-team all-conference guy. Next out, Hayden Decons out of Fort Benton. Decons, 6'6" sophomore, averages 10 a game, about 7 rebounds a game as well. And Michael but not least, Big Mike, a 6'7" junior. He averages nearly 12 points a game, and he wears number 42 out of Idaho, the junior Michael Yore.
You realize both these teams are so pumped up. Let's see what kind of action we get early.
Well, and you almost wonder if you have to reel it in a little bit. You know, these guys are fired up.
I'll tell you, I don't know names yet because I'm not a play-by-play guy, but number zero.
Hill.
Hill is ready. This guy has his game face on. Taji Hill. I love intensity anyway.
That's the deal right there. So Taji Hill.
I should have been a football player.
Ball goes in the air, and it will be controlled by Wayland Baptist. The Pioneers wearing the road black with the gold and blue. Montana Tech, the home whites. And we're rolling. Hill up top. Passes left. They're going to drop it down in the block. They'll attack. Shot tipped. Montana Tech with the rebound the other one. Krishan Dixon in a full house. Krishan, coast to coast, pass underneath. Decons fires, no. Tipped out of bounds, and that will be Pioneer basketball.
Yeah, somebody got a hand on the ball. Decons was going up with. Oh, crowd doesn't like it already. they're booing you, I think.
Probably.
All right, here we go.
There must be a lot of my family here. Wayland Baptist feeds it down on the block to Belfield. Belfield fighting, double team. Belfield kicks it out to the edge. Long range three, goes long, saved. Nice pass on the inside. Third attempt, no good. Montana Tech the other one. Krishan Dixon into the offensive zone. Michael Yore, ball fake. Mike will drive, shot no good. Now we're going to get a late whistle and a foul.
Yeah, he got hit from behind like a receiver getting hit by the strong safety of the 49ers. This is really a physical game right up. Right away. Give me the name.
Wayland Baptist.
Wayland Baptist. They're going right inside right away. Yeah. They're testing Michael Yore right off.
And they obviously did their homework on Big Mike as he kind of stopped right at the top of the arc and Belfield attacked him and he was able to get past him. Michael Yore at the line misses the front of two. And he'll get the ball for attempts number two. Mike, a 71% free throw shooter on the year, gets his second. Montana Tech on the board first, 1-0.
I told you early, these two teams, they've got to settle. They have to settle in. They really have the adrenaline pumping right now.
Across the timeline, Pioneers with it. Out near midcourt is Hill. Hill, bounce pass down to the baseline, Belfield. Belfield, double team, drops to him momentarily. He fights his way to the rack. Belfield, skyhook, and he gets it.
He's going to have to get some help here. They're going to have to dig down. He's too strong.
Belfield gives his head a little shake, back the other way defensively. Wayland Baptist leading 2-1. First time these two teams have met ever. Aza Williams up top. Williams passes left to Michael Yore. Yore down the corner for Sean Dixon. Dixon into the high post. He'll move it across to Belich. Belich fires and he gets it. Caleb Belich knocks it home. And Montana Tech leading 4-2.
That's big because he's one of those shooters. You give him his first shot or two, he's tough.
We're going to get a whistle and a foul as Michael Yore was falling to the ground. He was on Belfield. So Yore will pick up the foul, and that is going to bring Ifeanyi Okeke into the matchup. So Okeke checks in. Michael Yore goes out.
He didn't go out for the foul. He's going out because of the strength matchup.
Pioneers lob it into Belfield. Belfield draws the double team. Okeke. Shot comes up short, rebound saved by Okeke, but out, three-point shot up, no good. And here comes Belich the other one. Belich crossed the timeline into the offensive side we go. Feeds it underneath as Decons gets the pass to the points.
Great pass from Belich.
Great feed that time, and here come the digs the other way. Back defensively, Montana Tech leading 6-2. Through the double team, attacking, travel call.
Decons, great defense.
Yeah, Murray driving as Decons got a hand on it. And that will go to Montana Tech. So we'll go the other way here. Caleb Belich will bring her in. Montana Tech leading 6-2.
Wayland's got to settle down. They really were too high coming out of that. I think the crowd actually got them going.
So back the other way. Montana Tech with it. Aza Williams lost it. He'll pass it across right side to Okeke. Okeke looking on the interior. Instead comes up to Aza. He's going to fire that one up short. Decon saves it. And Montana Tech's Okeke gets it. Okeke driving through. Krishan is fouled. My goodness, physical right now. As a Montana Tech leading 6-2. Personal foul going to be charged to Rodney Carson Jr. And the Digs will inbound on their offensive zone. About 3 minutes gone here in this first half. It comes into Belly. Belly fires, rattles out. Tipped out. Here come the Pioneers. Down the other way, Hill. Hill, little stutter step. He's going to fire from 12. Follow-away jump shot, no good. Rebound battled for. Right back to the glass. Up and in is Rodney Carson. Carson gets the glass and the putback.
You know, everybody says box out, box out. This is one of those games that's going to be hard to box out.
Just the athleticism?
Just the athleticism.
6-4, Montana Tech by two. Decons out to Williams. Williams going to fire from the foul line and gets it. Asa Williams.
He wasn't happy with that air ball, so he said, I'm getting one on this next trip. Good
not
for him.
9-4.
Don't think, players, don't think that.
No, you can. That was written on his face, man. You could see that coming a mile away. Man, we have a packed house again. Thanks for joining us. Pull-up floater is short. That one's tipped out. Aza Williams will track it down. Williams steps through, goes up left-handed. Okeke with the offensive rebound, the putback. This place is fire right now. Montana Tech leading 10-4. Pioneers coach, as Coach Gallion will tell the boys to calm down a little bit as they come into the offensive zone. Around the screen, going left with it is Coleman. Coleman up top, three-point shot, no good. Decon's going to be called with a foul as Boltong will go to the stripe and shoot three.
Decon's not happy with himself. Got a hand, got him on the wrist.
15:54 left to play here in the first half. T-Bone is on the map, is on the mop. I think that's the most cleaning T-Bone Thatcher has ever done.
I think that's first Thatcher to do any work.
At the foul line, Tong shooting three. His first is good. 6'9" junior in Tong. Well, he is a long, athletic guy.
Yeah, they got beef with one post. This one's a slender one. Get the ball up, shoot, get it up over people.
And he'll get the ball for a second. Guy's kind of laughing it off in the key. Second is no good. 15:54 left to play in the first half. Michael Ure back in. Cam Lawrence, the sixth man of the year of the Frontier Conference, checks in. Also into the ball game is Keely Bake.
Ure got the matchup he needs. He cannot come out and guard Ure.
5-point lead for the Digs. Tong gets number three. So ball goes 2 of 3.
There goes the matchup. As soon as Ure come in, they're putting the big defensive tackle from the 49ers. This guy's big.
Yeah, he is big. DeMichael Belfield, 6'9" senior out of Texas. Up top to Michael Ure. Ure looking to his left, hands it off to Aza Williams. Sets a screen. Williams goes right side to Lawrence. Lawrence, a little shake and bake. He'll drive the lane. Back to his left side. Travel call.
Yeah, too many of them.
I mean, he still had 3 or 4 steps left in the NBA, but... Yeah.
Well, the reality is he's coming off the bench. He's got the adrenaline pumping.
That's
it. And it showed right there.
10-6, Montana Tech with the lead. Wayland Baptist a chance to trim that here. Pass goes wide left. 3-point shot, Leach, no good. Belfield with a big rebound. Belfield pulls down the offensive glass. He's looking to back it up. Turns to the baseline, goes down. And that is going to be going to Montana Tech.
Well, this guy's got every advantage down there on the block. He's got to turn and face and see what he's got. He can't just force backwards trying to make things happen because they're going to double him up now.
4-point lead for the Digs. Down the floor into the offensive side. Keely Bake around the screen. Bake puts on the brakes, fires it up to Michael Ure. Ure, ball fake, leans into the defender. Backdoor cut to Williams. Asa Williams slams it home.
That was pretty.
6-point lead for the Digs. Pioneers the other way. Driving through the paint, Jones. Jones passes left. Comes back up top. Ball fake. Nice move by Leach. He spins and draws the foul. Caleb Belich is going to pick up the personal.
Yeah, Asa, he reached in.
And we're going to get a timeout on the floor. Montana Tech leading 12-6, 14:44 left to play here in the first half. With a timeout, we'll take one. We're back right after this.
TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steel Furniture, making man caves happen for 87 years.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. First round of the NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. Montana Tech and Wayland Baptist throwing down the digs up 12-6. As we get back after it here, that one gets knocked out of bounds. Boy, the energy in this joint is crazy.
Yeah, Wayland Baptist has not settled down yet. They're still hyper.
So here come the digs across the timeline. Keeley Bake, top of the horn. Moving left, passes it off. Asa Williams gonna fire. Asa knocks it down.
And he's talking to the crowd.
Asa Williams with seven. And in case you have never been around Asa, Asa will talk to anything. he likes to talk. Love that kid. Wayland Baptist with it. As Belfield has it, Belfield leaves it off there. So Carson. Carson goes baseline. Nice take. Ball comes out. Block call. Michael Yore is going to pick up his second. This is an interesting lineup for Montana Tech with Yore and OKK both on the floor at the same time. This is something we have not seen much at all this year.
Well, Yore's coming out. That's two on him.
Decon,
we have not seen that. To take your point, well taken, but that's two quick fouls on Michael Yore.
And that will bring him out for a while. Decon will come in. Belich will come in as well.
Another thing of beauty, I don't care who's coming off the bench. They'll replace him. I mean, that's a pretty lucky thing to have when you're a coach.
The inbound to Carson. Carson Jr., top of the horn, switches to his left hand, left elbow, feeds it into Belfield. Belfield backing it up, strong to the basket. Belfield rolls it in.
Yeah.
Belfield has four.
He's like a bull in a china closet, man. You are not going to stop his progress.
Keeley Bake from downtown. That one doesn't go. And Wayland will grab the rebound back the other way. Tech leading by seven. They'll try the other way. That one's down as Quentin Coleman knocks it home. Coleman puts it down from the emblem. And here come the digs back the other way, leading by four. Belich circles around, moves it off. Keeley Bake, to OKK. OKK into the high post, moves it across Lawrence. Lawrence, a little shake and bake on the wing. Lawrence drives, taking his way into the paint. Floater is up, no good. Battled for, nice rebound that time by Leach.
And I'll tell you what, there is some physicality going on under those boards.
Brett Leach, the sophomore, has played very well here in the opening minutes for Wayland Baptist. No points in the book, but he's done just about everything else, it feels like. Tech by four. Pioneers, wide left out there is Carson in the corner. Three-point shot goes long, tracked down by OKK.
That was good defense by Belich over in that corner.
Belich up top, they'll move it here on the near side, OKK. Driving to the rack, Keeley Bake hits the bottom of the iron, draws the foul. Boy, that the seas parted for him, and he had a great lane to the rack.
Yeah, and he's a smart enough point guard to know he's not getting into the front part of the rim. He had to take it to the net in the rim, and that's why he got fouled. If he'd have went up, the ball would be at the other end of the court getting blocked. Smart. Well, you know I love the IQ of this player.
Yes, indeed. Keeley Bake at the line. Keeley, as we take a look, 82% from the line. His first here is money. So Keeley Bake. Talked to him quite a bit as this week went on, and just asking him how long the week has felt like it's gone, and he's like, it's just snail pace.
Yeah.
It has been the longest week of his life.
That's a player.
Bake, his second. He is on the way and good. Keely Bake goes 2-of-2, his first 2 points of the day. Montana Tech leading 17-11 here over the Pioneers out of Wayland Baptist. Into the offensive side, Coleman. Coleman averages 14 a game for the Pioneers. He'll move it off. Belfield back to Coleman. Coleman behind the back, through the lane. Great take! That one won't go, but he's going to shoot two. Keely Bake's going to be, no, actually, it's going to go on OK Tech. Well, I thought it was going to go to Keely, personally.
Well, I thought Keely had good position, so understandable.
That'll put Quinton Coleman at the line. Coleman has 1 3-pointer today. And his first free throw of the evening knocks it down. So Coleman has 4 points on the day. He'll get the ball for attempt number two. 12:28 left to play here in the first half. Tech leading 17-12. Coleman gets the ball for attempt number two. Tremendous guard here for Wayland Baptist. That one, boy, I thought it was going to be short, and it falls right in. 5 points for Quinton Coleman. Tech's lead is four. Diggs have led by as much as nine. Didn't last very long. Down the floor, Krishan Dixon to Belich in the high post. Inside, Deacons. Deacons bodied up. Triple team to the right side. 3-point shot. Krishan Dixon, no good. Rebound out of bounds.
Lawrence over the back.
Lawrence came over the top. Cam will pick up the personal.
He got the look they needed. Just didn't knock it down.
8 minutes gone here in the ball game. Montana Tech leading 17-13. The Digs shooting 46%. Wayland Baptist at 30%. 7 rebounds each way. Wayland with 3 turnovers. Montana Tech with 1. Montana Tech, number 5 in the country for turnovers or lack thereof. Good ball movement into the hands of Murray. Murray shot. Boy, what a take by Murray.
I thought he got hit in the head.
I thought his shot was partially blocked on top of it. Belich looked to answer. No good. And pulled down by Belfield. Wayland Baptist, chance to tie it up, possibly take a lead here on this possession. They'll move it out of the wide left side. Long range three, rims out. Aza Williams with a rebound. Tech outlet to Belich. That one gets knocked out of play. They'll stay out of bounds off of Belly.
They got it right.
From our angle, it looked that way. Taja Hill was the defender that way. And the Pioneers down the floor. So the Pioneers into the offensive zone, trailing by 2. 11:20 left to play here in the first half. Pass goes out on the left side to Leach. Leach, top of the key, 3-point shot, money. Just inside the arc, rather, as Murray knocks down the jumper, and we're tied at 17. Tech was up by 9, and Wayland Baptist has settled in a little bit here now. Aza Williams, he's going to fire. 3 wide left. Belfield with a rebound. So that will go back, and here come the Pioneers, a chance to grab a lead here. Approaching the midway point of the first half, Pioneers with a basketball. Wide left with it is Murray. Murray up top to Hill. Hill behind the back, puts on the brakes. Good defense that time. Pass tipped out, and he hit it. That should have been over and back. Long range three off the glass and in for Quinton Coleman.
I got away with one there.
8 points for Coleman, and Wayland Baptist goes up 20-17. Nice shot by Coleman from way downtown. And we're going to get an offensive as OKK going to be called with the moving screen. So everything going the way of the Pioneers right now. 10:21 left to play here in the first half.
Yeah, Tech can't get rattled over that over and back call because it definitely wasn't over and back. They touched it. You can't get rattled by that kind of stuff. You got to get your composure back.
Pioneers into the zone. Quinton Coleman, who just knocked one down from about 35, it felt like, to the baseline. Coleman gets it back. Hill moves up top. Good job. 3-point shot again. What a big one by Quinton Coleman.
That was acrobatic.
My goodness, Coleman feeling it right now for the Pioneers. Montana Tech around the screen. Deedon gets it. Deedon, good defensive pressure. Deedon spins, attacks. He gets it in the foul. Bridger Deedon.
Big off the bench. Big.
That's honestly where I was going with it. I mean, we talk about Tech bringing guys off the bench. He comes in and makes a monster play.
Both coaches need to settle them both down now, right now. This is a good timeout.
9:48 left to play here in the first half. We have a timeout on the floor. Wayland Baptist by four with a timeout. We'll take one. We're back right after this.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Back here after the timeout as first round of the NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. Pioneers at Wayland Baptist 21-9 on the season, 15-7 in the Sooner Athletic Conference. They lead by four over Montana Tech.
So Tech's had their run. They were up by nine. Wayland's come back and they're up by three. Oh, four.
Deaton, that one rims out.
Thought that was down.
9:45 left to play in the first half. Down the floor, Wayland Baptist. Across the timeline, Taji Hall. Hall looking to his left. Boy, Wayland Baptist really has settled into the offensive side of things right now. Murray, step back. He's going to fire from 15. Off the glass, no good. Decons with a rebound.
He's got a new post player in. 23, you see a post player? Yeah,
that's the deal. Jackson Reeser. Keely Bake in the corner. Drives through the paint. Moves it up top. Asa Williams. Three ball is good. The Digs are within one. Asa had 31 points in the conference championship game against Carroll College. His last game out. He has Wayland Baptist leading by one. Top of the horn, driving Leach into the paint. Shot blocked, Decons. Boy, he read that like
not
a book.
Not for more, one moment was he going to get that shot off.
Keely Bake gets hammered as he lets it go, and he's going to shoot three. Keely Bake will go to the line and shoot three here. Keely just hasn't found the constant groove this year. You know, he's had a couple games where he's hit it well. He's shooting 35% from the arc on the year. And he will go to the stripe here shooting three, 82% from the foul line on the year. He has 2 points thus far. Both of those from the stripe. His first here rattles out no good.
He's right now, I know a little bit about this. He's got to get his adrenaline pumped down a little bit. He's not playing the basketball that he's really good at.
Yeah, he has that. He's best when he runs the ice water.
When he creates, runs, yep, and gets wide open. He was in a hurry to take that three. Fortunately for him, he got fouled. But he's got to calm down a little bit.
Keely Bake, 3 of 4 from the foul line, shooting one more. 8:47 remaining here in the first half. We're tied at 23. That is our second tie. Keely tried to give us the lead, does not. Here comes Wayland Baptist back the other way. Pioneers with the rock. It's great to see them here in the Mining City. Packed house here at Kelvin Sampson Court. Long range three goes wide right. Asa Williams, great hustle, tracks it down.
Not a shot I'd like as a coach at all.
Asa moves it up to Decons. Decons right side, Keely Bake. Bake attacks, Keely to the rack, high off the glass. Keely Bake rolls it in.
That's a control Keely Bake right there.
Tech leads by two, 25-23. Wayland Baptist is much different with Belfield on the floor than without Belfield on the floor.
Oh, no question.
Hill wide left, Hill, nice, step through, goes up, ball stripped away, Tech basketball, and now a collision and a foul. Decon step through the double team, and the personal foul gonna be charged to Tom. So Bolton will pick up the personal, Montana Tech leading 25-23. My goodness. What an environment here in the Mining City. We're packed to the rafters. The Warriors are into the second round. We'll find out who their opponent will be here. 7:54 remaining in the first half. Tech by two over Wayland Baptist. Krishan Dixon into Deacon's floater, no good.
2-3 zone, Wayland come out in that time.
Belfield gets the rebound, clears it across to Hill. Hill, ball knocked away from him for a minute, gets it back under control into Belfield. Belfield looking to back it up. Nice pass on the inside. Tech gets the rebound, and we're going to get a whistle. Let's see what we get here. Krishan Dixon, it looks like, is going to pick up the personal.
Yeah, I'd have been surprised if he wasn't fouled. That was an easy shot, really.
And at the line is Rodney Carson. Carson with 2 points on the day. His first free throw is up and out, no good. So Wayland Baptist, 4 of 6 from the foul line today. And they'll get the ball for attempt number two. Montana Tech leading 25-23. Rodney Carson, the 6'3" senior at the line. His second rim's out. Belfield with the second attempt, no good. Montana Tech the other way. Belfield is a monster inside.
Yes, she is.
In the corner, 3-point shot. Keeley Bake, no good. Belfield gets another rebound.
Belfield's my kind of post player. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, he is large.
Yeah, he is.
6 rebounds for Belfield thus far, and he has been an absolute force. Driving through the lane, right-handed, no good. Belfield, another rebound of the putback. Belfield with 6.
Got great hands for a man that big.
6 offensive rebounds for Wayland Baptist. 4 second-chance points thus far.
3-2 zone now.
We're tied up 25-all. And a whistle and a foul. Rodney Carson tried to reach in and got a big old piece of Hayden Deacon's. So that will go on Carson. That's his second. Team foul number 7. Both teams in the bonus here. And Deacon's will go to the line for the Dicks. Deacon's 60% from the stripe.
What's that, 3-2 or 1-2-2 zone? It's 3-2 when he's down on the free throw line. It's 1-2-2 when he's at the top of the key, the point guard, to match up with the three-point shooters. They feel that Ace's threes are really hurting them.
Deacon's at the line, shooting the 1-1. Southpaw, front half of the bonus, is off the iron, no good. And the rebound controlled by the Pioneers. Down the floor we go.
One run, another run, now nothing.
Taji Hill into the offensive zone, tied up 25-all. Pass out to Hill. Hill outside the arc. Cam Lawrence on him defensively, switched up. Belich now. Hill lost it for a moment, picks it up, pass out on the right side, controlling Tucker. And Tucker is going to be called with a double dribble. Put it on his hip.
Put it on his hip.
So put it on his hip, called with a double dribble. Montana Tech will get the turnover here. 6:20 left to play in the first half. We're tied up 25-all. Montana Tech 4 wide. Lawrence, high dribble. Pass goes out into the high post. Jump shot, Caleb Belich's money. Belich has 5, Montana Tech by 2. Tournament action here in the Mining City. Thanks for joining us on Digger Vision. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher. As Taji Hill drives, floater is up, hits the side of the backboard, gets his own rebound, passes it out on the right wing. Step through, jump stop, shot, no. Rebound controlled, OKK. OKK across to Dixon. Dixon double teamed, out to Williams. Williams fires, rims out. Pioneers with the rebound, quickly in transition. They'll get into the offensive zone and slow it down. 5:30 left to play in the first half. 2-point lead for Tech. Belfield through the paint. Sky hook, no good. That one gets knocked out of bounds, and it will be Montana Tech ball. Boy, there are some collisions under the basket.
It's the way the game's supposed to be played.
I put that on the tee for you. I wasn't sure you were going to take
well,
a swing.
I did. I got a swing. Just drove it 350 yards.
Tech is led by 9. Wayland Baptist is led by 6. And we have had ourselves a chess match.
Come out of the 1-2-2 zone. Now going man.
Krishan Dixon to Belich. Belich goes up. Ball stripped away. And here comes Wayland the other one. Down the floor into the offensive side. Murray through the lane. Reverse. Gets it up and in. Boy, nice take by Murray. He has 6 points. We're tied at 27.
That is a transition bucket. He got it there.
Four ties thus far in this ball game. Belich eyed the three, goes to Asa Williams. Williams cross court up top to Okeke. Okeke left side. Nice pass inside, and the finish by Cam Lawrence. Krishan Dixon with a wonderful bounce pass. Tech leading 29-27, 4:30 left to play in the first half. It's amazing, we've had some significant runs as far as transition, but then we've had some good runs of just half-court basketball too. Little shake and bake on the wing, through the lane to the rack. That's a great take by Jones. Javonte Jones gets his first field goal. Cam Lawrence under the basket, shot no. 29 all, our fifth tie. Wayland Baptist looking to change that with his possession. Taji Hill out of midcourt, moving left. Gets it off to Belfield. Belfield spins to his left, shot blocked by Okeke, and he slams it up into the elbow.
Tech ball.
So Montana Tech will get the basketball. Great adjustment by Okeke, and we have a timeout on the floor. We're tied up 29-all, 3:49 left to play in the first half. With a timeout on the floor, we'll take one. We're back here on Digger Vision right after this.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then Aim Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Hey, we're back here once again, 3:49 left to play in the first half as the NAI National Tournament here on a Friday evening. Game two here in the first round. The winner of this one will take on the Warriors of Lewis Clark State. As the Warriors won the first round matchup with Hope International.
Did I ever tell you nothing comes easy this time of year in basketball?
Nothing. 29-all, Montana Tech, Keeley Bake into the offensive zone. Across to Asa Williams. Williams feeds it down inside to Lawrence in the bottom right corner. Lawrence trying to get space. Lawrence pump fake once, floater no good. Defensive rebound brought in, and Wayland back the other way. Big rebound by Leach. Leach gets it across to Hill. Tech shooting 44%, Wayland at 37%. Great pass to Belfield, and he's going to be fouled as Deedon lands on his back. The most amazing part of that is Deedon landed on his back, and it didn't even look like Belfield registered it.
He didn't even move. I know.
That was amazing.
And that's exactly why Deedon's in there, for the physicality
exactly.
Part of the game.
Yep.
He did not even move.
He landed on his back like he was going to jump into a papoose. So Belfield gets his first, Deedon's first personal foul. 3:20 left to play here at the half. As grabbing another lead is the Pioneers out of Wayland Baptist. They lead 30-29. Second, no good. Deacon's blocking out, gets the rebound. Tech the other one. Wayland Baptist back defensively. Montana Tech looking to grab the lead back here. Deedon to Asa Williams. Williams drives, floater, gets it off the glass and in.
Yeah, could have had a foul call, got his legs.
He was calling the official for one. 3 minutes left to play in the first half. Hill drives, shot blocked by Deedon. Deedon swipes it in transition. Asa Williams rims out. Tipped out, and underneath, Belich gets the rebound and the putback. Belich has 7, Tech by 3. 2:38 left to play here in the first half. Hill across midcourt. Lulls him across. Keeley Bate calling for a carry. Wayland up top with it. That's Murray. Fall away jumper, no good. Long rebound. Deacons tracks it down. Moves it across to Belich. Good hustle by Deacons. Belich, top of the horn. He's going to fire. Belich, back of the rim, no. Tipped out. Belfield with another rebound.
Not the shot Coach Hyatt wanted.
Belfield has 8 rebounds in the first half. 2 minutes left to play here in this first 20 minutes. Hill dribbles out with it. Steps through. Floater from 8. Rolls it in. That's Hill's first field goal.
That's athleticism at its finest.
Down the floor to Belich. Belich moves it up top to Deedon. Deedon now to Williams. They looked at a screen up top. Aza Williams holds on to it, moves to his right around a screen. Pick and roll to Deedon. Deedon puts it up off balance and gets it.
Deedon's player of the game so far. This guy has got things done.
That's a big-time shot by Deedon. Bounced off the defender and still was able to roll that in somehow. 90 seconds remaining in the first half. A tremendous first half. Tech by 3. Back out to Hill. Hill around a screen going left. Had a little bit of an opening. He passes left horn. Comes back up top. Looking to his right the whole way. He's going to drive. Shot clock at 5. Hill off balance. No. Deacon's going to pick up the foul.
I didn't watch the finish of that defense. I was watching the shots. It would go in.
I was right with you. I did the same darn thing. Tech leading 35-32. And at the foul line, Hill. So Taji Hill will shoot some free throws here. The junior averages 13 a game. His first is money. Wayland Baptist. What are we looking at here? 1, 2, 3. They're 6 of 10 from the foul line. And Hill will shoot his second. Tech leads by 2, 35-33. Deacons checks out. And Hill back at the line for number 2. Gets it. 4 points on the day for Hill. Tech leads by 1. Montana Tech has been up by 9 here in the first half. Wayland Baptist with a 6-point lead of their own. Keely Bake calling for motion. Far right wing, picks up his dribble, moves it up to Aza Williams. Williams draws a quick double team, backs out of it, moves it here near side. Lawrence back to Williams. Williams into the triple team, passes tip to take it away. Quickly the other way, Murray. Murray attacks way up off the glass, no good. And on the rebound, a whistle and a foul. Going up for the rebound was Keely Bake, and he was fouled by Jackson Reeser. Keely Bake, the rebounding machine, was giving up like a foot and a half to Reeser. And Reeser picks up the personal. Keely Bake will shoot some free throws.
Yeah, he was giving up a foot and a half, but the key was he was in front of him and had his body against him.
So at the foul line again is Keely Bake. He's 3 of 5 from the stripe today. 43.5 seconds remaining here in the first half. Keely, front half of the bonus, money. Keely Bake, now 4 of 6 from the free throw line. And he'll get ready for attempt number 2. Tech leads by 2. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. Championship game here at the of this four-person or four-team tournament, if you will, was tomorrow at 6 p.m. Lewis Clark State. Out of Lewis and Idaho, the number 11 seed advanced as they took down Hope International, the 6th seed. Keely Bake gets his second. 7 points for Keely. Tech leads by 3, 37-34. As they come into the offensive zone, Wayland Baptist will call a timeout. Short timeout. And that will be the call. So 38 seconds remaining here in the first half. Montana Tech leading 37-34. NAIA first round action here on Digger Vision. JT, they get it across midcourts. What do you think they're going to set up here?
You know what? In this day and age, this era, everything's on a high screen up on top. So look for them to do something like that. Or they may hit the post and run a double screen down on the other side of the key. So I don't know this team well enough to figure it out. I'd have to watch film and I could tell you exactly what they were going to do. I could.
A 3-point lead for the Digs, 37-34. Wayland Baptist out of the timeout. They're going to bring in a couple bigs here as Belfield is in. Boltong is on the floor as well. Jones is there.
I don't think Tech is a good team to run backdoor plays with. They're so well coached at preventing that. I don't think this is a good time.
The inbound to Hill. Bounce pass moves it out on the left wing. Back to Hill now up top. Moving right. Shot clock at 15. Tong fires the three. No good. Rebound controlled. Montana Tech plenty of time. Down the floor. Pass out to Deedon. Deedon will get into the offensive zone and call the timeout.
Truthfully.
Heads up play by Deedon.
They didn't set up a play. They did not set up a play.
I like that heads up play by Deedon. He grabbed the ball, pointed at coach. Coach called the timeout, and now the Digs will set something up with 20.5 seconds remaining here in this first half. Michael Uhr will come back in after spending some quality time on the bench with two personal fouls in the first half.
Yeah, well, they need him in there. And it's, again, we're going to talk a game of wear and tear, altitude, and a lot of things here. I can see Tech, because they're using their bench, wearing this team down a little bit. The only real bench that Wayland has is their three post players. Other than that, they're not making a tremendous amount of changes.
Three-point lead for Montana Tech over Wayland Baptist. Tech, the number three seed here in the quadrant. Wayland Baptist, the number 14 seed in the quadrant. And we have had ourselves a good one here in this first half. 20 seconds remaining here. Montana Tech, a inbound right off the edge of the Wayland bench.
I think they need to find Michael Uhr right now. You got to find out how this post player is going to play him on the perimeter and inside.
Asa Williams.
Well, he's on Bellage, so.
See what we get going here. Asa Williams at midcourts. Game clock down to 10.
I like this.
Here comes the move. Aza around a screen. Pass out right side. Cam Lawrence going to fire. Lawrence shot. No good. 2 seconds. Pass left. And firing at the horn. It's on its way and no good. We have 20 minutes in the books. And Montana Tech leads by 3. 37-34. The Ore Diggers up over the Pioneers. First round of the NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. We'll give you the numbers, talk about the first half and more right after this.
We really wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything. Really, the personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank, Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
I think there's more than one thing that makes Montana Tech unique.
I think it's incredible. It's special.
I've always kind of thrived off the adventure side of things and the unknown. There's no place I'd rather be going to school.
Montana Tech has provided me more than I ever could have expected.
Montana Tech made me a trailblazer.
Montana Tech made me a healer.
Montana Tech is my solution.
Be the solution. Visit Montana Tech today.
Welcome back here once again. We are at the half. Montana Tech leading 37-34 over the Pioneers out of Wayland Baptist. John Thatcher, give us your take on the opening half, brother.
Great half. We had a big run by Tech, and we had a big run by Wayland, and then the runs ran out. They just started competing back and forth, trading baskets. But truthfully, I thought Wayland Baptist played a little bit out of control that half. I think it hurt them. I thought they took some shots that were questionable that they probably shouldn't have. And then I think Tech was a little bit excited when their bench came in. They got big time play from Deedon, but I thought Keely Bake was a little bit nervous, and I thought Lawrence was a little bit nervous coming into this thing. So they just got to go and settle down now, come out, run their stuff, and do. I think both teams have got to run their offenses maybe a little better, maybe take too quick a shot.
Okay, let's run through the numbers individually, then we'll take a look at the team numbers here in just a moment. Individually, we'll start things off for Wayland Baptist right now. They have seven guys in the book scoring right now. They're led by Coleman. Quinton Coleman has 11 points, 3 3-pointers. He's 2 of 2 from the foul line. He has 11 points as of right now. DeMichael Belfield has 7 points, and that's nothing compared to his 8 rebounds, as he has just been an absolute monster on
the
inside. So Belfield, 7 points, 8 rebounds for Wayland Baptist. Looks like Taji Hill has 4 points on the day. Jones has a basket for 2. Murray has 6 points. All of those real athletic drives to the basket. Murray has made some really nice plays. Bull Tong has 2 points right now. And Rodney Carson Jr. has a basket for 2 points for the Pioneers out of Wayland Baptist.
Well, Belich has got to get a few more looks, too. I think he is too big a hurry to shoot a three. He really has a size advantage with the guy defending him. And I think he's got to get down on the block a little bit, bring him to the short corner of the corner, and then unload the basketball. But I think he's got to get more shots. Asa Williams has done a great job. He hurried a couple threes. So you're not going to win this thing in one little stretch. It's going to be a time changer, and you've got to gradually play some great defense and then make your run. And whoever has that success this second half will win this.
Taking a look at the team numbers for Wayland Baptist as of right now. They're shooting 33% from the floor. They're 12 of 36. They're 3 of 11 from downtown at 27% and 63% from the foul line. As you take a look at the numbers there on your screen, taking a look at the Montana Tech team numbers. Right now here, the Digs shooting 45% from the floor, 23% from downtown. They're 3 of 13 and 55% from the free throw line. They're 6 of 11, and that has been kind of the case. They've had some days where they've had trouble from the free throw line through the tournaments and kind of the end of the season, honestly.
Yeah, I think free throw shooting been a little bit of their Achilles heel during the season. They went, like you said, they went through stretches where they'd have 2 or 3 bad games, and they'd go 12 for 15 or 16 for 18. Then today they're right back into the, you got to make your free throws in big games. Got to make them.
Individual numbers for Montana Tech right now. They're led by Asa Williams with 12 points. He's the leading scorer on the floor. He has 2 3-pointers, 3 field goals inside as well. He's 5 of 10 from the floor for the Ore Diggers out of Montana Tech. Caleb Belich has 7 points, 1 3-pointer, 2 field goals on the inside. Keely Bake also 7 points. He's 5 of 7 from the foul line, 1 field goal to add to that total. Bridger Deedon with 4 points, Cam Lawrence with 2, Okeke with 2, and Michael Ure 1 point on the day, as he is 1 of 2 from the free throw line for the Ore Diggers out of Montana Tech.
Yeah, well, they're getting scoring out of everybody, so that's really critical. And right now, for the first time all season, I'm going to say this, the bench has got to play better. Deedon come in, did a hell of a job, but he slopped in 2 shots that probably most of the time wouldn't go in. Keely Bake, frustrated a little bit when he first came in because he didn't hit some threes, missed a couple free throws. Well, he's loosened up now. He got his thing done. I think they need better play. I think they need some scoring. Okiki's going to be in there. I think they need some scoring. When he's out here on the perimeter, they just take away the middle of the key because he's not a threat to shoot the three. So I think some way, shape, or form, they got to get him with some penetration or get him down on the block and let him do a little work.
Some of those team numbers right now. Wayland Baptist, 22 rebounds. Montana Tech with 20, so not near as heavily favored for Wayland Baptist as I was truly expecting. 22-20, rebounding edge of 2 for the Pioneers. Down the list, Montana Tech 4 turnovers. Wayland Baptist with only 5 right now. And from there, let's go back to rebounding for a second. Wayland has 7 offensive rebounds for 4 second chance points. Montana Tech 3 offensive rebounds for 4 second chance points as well. It really, from there, you know, not a whole lot. The other big one is bench points, and it's one of those that we certainly are used to. Montana Tech 15 points off the bench. Wayland was 6 so far after 20 minutes.
Yeah, well, I'm just kind of analyzing this thing in this warped old brain, and the bench has got to play a little bit better for Tech to get out here to win it. And I think Wayland's got that. They've taken some shots that I wouldn't have been happy with if I was a coach, and I'd have let them know it. And so they've got to settle down a little bit, take a better shot. Tech has got to do a better job. And the nice thing, both these teams are taking care of the basketball. I'll tell you, this is an up-and-down quick game. turnovers really aren't a factor in this game at all. Neither is rebounding.
Yeah.
So let's go to the free throw line. Tech's not shooting them very well. They actually should probably have about a 9 or 10 point lead right now if they're making their free throws.
We're at the half. Montana Tech leading Wayland Baptist 37-34. First round matchup between the Digs and the Pioneers. The winner of this one will play tomorrow at 6 p.m. against the Warriors out of Lewis Clark State. And of course, we'll have that for you here on Digger Vision. John Thatcher, Paul Podisco, and our crew here on a Friday. Let's take a break. We'll come back. We'll talk about some other numbers and get you ready for the second half after this.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, welcome back here once again. First round of the NAIA Men's National Tournament here in Butte, Montana. Second year in a row, the Ore Diggers have hosted here at Kelvin Sampson Court. And, I mean, as one would expect, we have been treated to some fantastic basketball here on this Friday night.
This Friday and all season long, yeah, with this team, it's just been a great basketball team to watch.
We have had, we certainly have a packed house here tonight, and hopefully you're enjoying the broadcast. And, of course, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. As we get ready for the second half here, JT, let's kind of break it down. Wayland Baptist coming out on the floor first, so let's talk about the Pioneers. Thank you. Pioneers, if you're looking at the Pioneers right now, what do you need to get started here in the first 5 minutes?
Well, I think they've got to be a little more patient offensively. They chucked up some shots that I as a coach didn't care for at all. I think they got to be a little more patient and run their stuff. I love going inside out. The big has got to learn to react to defensive situations. He's catching the ball, wanting to back people down right away, and they're getting in. He's having a little trouble when he gets within 1 or 2 feet, got that baby jump hook. But he's surrounded by two people. He's got to read better, make some kicks out, and then get penetration.
Let's switch the coin and go to the Montana Tech side of things. John Thatcher, what do the Digs need to get started here earlier? What's important for them to get comfortable in the offensive side?
I think they have to push the basketball, make good decisions, and I don't think the decision is necessarily to catch it, get it around the perimeter, and shoot a three. I'd like to see Michael Europe settle down a little bit, get himself on the outside. I thought he was kind of pushing himself a little bit early, got himself in foul trouble. He's okay now. Get him back onto the perimeter and see who can guard him and who can't.
37-34, Wayland Baptist, the Pioneers, 21-9 on the year. They're coming out of the Sooner Athletic Conference. They're 15-7 in conference play. Montana Tech, 26-4 overall, 14-1 in Frontier Conference play. The Digs, number 8 in the final NAIA Top 25 Coaches poll. And it has been an awesome first half here. We've seen a couple runs early, but I don't think as nearly as many runs as honestly we kind of expected to see in that first 20 minutes.
No, I expected 3 or 4 runs. There were two.
Yep.
That was it. I expected 3 or 4 in the first half. It's like I'm scoring, you're scoring, and now let's don't anybody score. So it's been an interesting game, but we'll see some more runs here this half.
Well, as these teams get ready to roll again, join us tomorrow at 6 p.m. for the championship. We'll have that for you here once again on Digger Vision. The winner of this one will take on the Warriors out of Lewis Clark State College. And certainly looking forward to that one tomorrow, but a lot of business yet to be done here tonight.
Well, this is far from over. It's going to come down to field goal percentage. Once again, I'm talking patience with both teams. Tech does not have the inside game to compete with these guys, so they're doubling down because they know they're being handled by the Hulk here. This guy's a good basketball player for as big as he has, got great hands. So it's going to be a contrast of interest here, but I think the ball's got to enter for Wayland, and I think Tech's got to be real patient and take a good look at the shots they're taking.
Well, as the teams get warmed up here for the second half, we have a packed house here at Kelvin Sampson Courts. And we're getting ready for the second half here. As obviously a busy weekend around the country, there are 16 sites for the women's tournament, 16 sites for the men's tournament. And once we get through tomorrow, we'll find out who the final 16 teams are going to be in Kansas City on the men's side of the coin.
That's quick work in 2 days, isn't it? Go from 64 to 16.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
I am such a fan of this. You know, I think I love the, you know, a 64-team tournament at one venue is great. But on the other hand, 8 o'clock games are just hard. You know, they're just hard.
I know. I just
took the wind out of you.
Yeah, you did.
But, you know, these scenarios where you bring three teams to a host, I think you get great basketball. I think you get tremendous environments. I think this has been a fantastic change. And then you go to 16 teams, and you don't have to worry about, you know, stacking up 8 games a day for like 3 days in a row. You can really, you know, boil it down from 16 at one single site.
Well, some of these teams complain it's too costly. But when I coached back here in the 80s, if you were lucky to host a playoff game, you were lucky. Otherwise, you had to travel twice. It cost you more money then than it does today because you bring it all in one time to one venue. And I like this. I like this format. I really like this format.
Well, as these two teams get ready to roll, we have 20 minutes out. All right, let's hear it. How many remaining runs do we have in the final 20 minutes of this one?
We'll have two more this half.
Two more?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I'm going to go ahead and write that down. In pen, mind you.
Write her down, buddy.
Diggs leading 37-34 over Wayland Baptist. The Pioneers in town taking on the Ore Diggers. And everything I was told about this Wayland Baptist team has been true. They're physical. They're going to get after. They're incredibly athletic. And boy, they match up well with Tech. This has been a really fun first half to this point.
Oh, excellent first half, and two well-coached basketball teams.
Yep, that's the deal right there. So we're about to get our horn, and we are ready to roll here in the second half. Again, Wayland Baptist shot 33% in the first half. Montana Tech shot 45% in that first half. Fouls as we make our way through it. Coleman, Leach, and Carson each have two for Wayland Baptist. On the other side, Montana Tech, Deacons, Michael, Yore, and OKK each with two.
Well, let's have fun, guys. Here we go. This is your season or not.
So we are rolling. Montana Tech by three. Pioneers with the ball. Into the offensive zone, Coleman. He had a fantastic first half. He has 11 points. Leading scorer for the Pioneers. Baseline spin move back out to Coleman. Coleman feeds down to the block. Fighting, right-handed off the rack and in for DeMichael Belfield.
Can't let him have it that deep. How come I knew they're going to the post right away to start this off, and they're going to it a lot more.
Agreed. Especially when Ure is on the floor. Deacon steps through, and he will be fouled. Great take by Deacon. Coleman gets up slowly. He'll pick up his second personal.
Coleman is not big enough to be getting run over by these big guys. I'll tell you, he took a hard hit there.
He's been impressive today. The 5'10" junior.
Yeah, he's a player.
These two rosters are impressive. They're just doing a really nice job. Coleman checks out. In for him is going to be Rodney Carson Jr.
I want to know who beat Wayland this year so many times.
Seven times in conference.
Yes.
The inbound to Belich. Belich lobs it to Deacons. Pump fake. Deacons with a left hand and in. Deacons with 4 points. Is it Langston? I know Langston's in the sack. They're, I think, the number two team in the country.
They are, aren't they?
I think they lost to them twice during the regular season and in the semifinals. I think the last two were like 2-point ball games, though. They'll roll it into Belfield. Nice pass across. Shot partially tipped.
Belich.
And Montana Tech will come the other way with it.
Big block by Belich.
Deacons gets it. Backing it up left wing. Out to Belich. He's going to pop it. 3-point shot. High bounce. No good. Rebound by Hill. Montana Tech is 3 of 14 from the three-point line. They'll look to go the other way. Three ball is up and in for Hill.
Nobody put any pressure on him all the way down the court. That's his shot.
7 points for Hill. We're tied at 39. That is our sixth tie. And Deacons moves it across to Belich, now to Asa Williams. Williams, double team, moves it up top. Michael Ure fakes the shot, moves it across to Williams. Williams wanted the baseline, good defense by Hill. Williams, double team, off the glass, no good. He goes to the ground hard, the other way, here comes Carson. Carson drops it off.
Travel.
And a travel call. So the travel will go to Montana Tech. That is turnover number 8 for Wayland Baptist.
Again, we go back to slow down a little bit. That's not necessary.
2 minutes gone here in the second half. Montana Tech basketball. Asa Williams moves it across. Krishan Dixon to Ure in the corner, Belich. Belich with a right hand, looking it up top, Krishan Dixon. Now to Ure. Michael Ure with the right hand, drives through the lane, lost the dribble for a moment, fights his way to the rack and gets it. Boy, he stuck with it all the way deep. And that's his first field goal, 3 points for Michael Ure.
This is truly the first big that could come out and guard him on the three-point line. That's just a great spin move to get him to the bucket.
2.5 gone here in the second half, Tech by 2. Wayland Baptist, Belfield hands it off. Makes the move, shot gets wedged. Deacon's gonna pick up his third personal. The athleticism between Deacon's and Murray is scary. These two are just insanely athletic.
Well, like Dennis Rodman, they're freaks. They are so athletic.
Yep. Well, they're kind of built along the same mold. Murray, like, look at his arms as he's it. He's what they've always called positive. You know, his your arms when you spread your arms out are supposed to be the same height as you are tall, and you can tell that he is positive, where his arm wingspan is actually longer than he is tall, and Deacons is the same way. I mean, just really insane athleticism. Asa Williams going left, nice pass to Dixon. Dixon through the lane, right-handed Krishan Dixon. They need a little bit of input from Krishan. He puts that one in, Tech by 4. 43-39, Diggs by 4. That feels like the biggest lead we've seen in like a half hour. Wayland moves it across right side to Hill. Hill, top of the horn, he's gonna fire. Hill knocks in another one.
Well, they're gonna, Deacon's a struggle. That's two Hills hit out there. He's gotta get out, make him put it to the floor and get some help.
Hill, the transfer from Temple, puts the lead at 1. Montana Tech leading 43-42. Backdoor to Deacon. Somehow he caught that, but he stepped out of bounds. Turnover will go to the Pioneers.
Yeah, that was a tough pass. He was well defended.
I'm shocked he made the, he caught that thing first off, and then stepping out of bounds.
Yeah, it was pretty deep.
Tech by 1. Diggs shooting 60% here in this second half. Only to be outdone by Wayland at 75%. Wayland 3 of 4 from the floor, Tech 3 of 5. Here comes Hill into the offensive zone. Bounce pass down to the bottom deep corner. Baseline take, double team, almost taken away by Belich. Good defensive pressure by Belich. Inside it goes to Belfield. Belfield fights, he's gonna get the offensive.
Absolutely.
Big elbow to Michael Belfield. Swung that elbow. That's his first personal. Tech gets the basketball.
Coach didn't like it, but the reality is he run right over him.
We had a really good angle on that.
Yeah, looks he's looking right at it.
I think everybody had a really good angle on that. Tech by 1. Belich hands it off. They'll move it around the arc. Asa Williams. Williams to Belich. Belich bottom left corner. He wants the baseline. Belich, wraparound pass for Sean Dixon. Krishan finishes.
That's a great teammate play right there. Nice pass, Belly.
Krishan Dixon gets the basket. Tech by 3, 45-42. Wayland Baptist out around the screen. Coleman. The guards, Coleman and Hill, really having great ball games here for the Pioneers. Coleman has Krishan on him. Coleman drives. Nice goes with the right shot. Hand.
Didn't finish.
Shot no good. Belfield with the offensive rebound of the putback. 1 point lead for the Dicks. Pass goes wide left. Belich now in the corner to Dixon. Dixon driving through the paint, puts on the brakes, kicks it out left side. Michael Ure from the corner, front of the iron, no good. That one goes out of bounds. We don't see Mike take too many threes from the corner. Almost all of yours are from the top of the key.
I was thinking that's the first time I've ever seen him shoot one from the corner.
I'm not sure it isn't the first for me as well. 45-44, Tech by one. 5 minutes gone here in the second half. We'll take a break. We're back here to Kelvin Sampson Court right after this.
Showroom today for ideas to upgrade your bar set, fireplace, TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steel's Furniture, making man caves happen for 87 years.
Hey, welcome back here after the timeout. 5 minutes gone here in the second half. Montana Tech leading 45-44. As after the timeout, the Digs looking inbound. They do sit to OKK. Now to Keely Bake. Bake wide left, switches to his right hand, moves it out on the right side. Cam Lawrence. Rants into the high post, turns to his right, bounces it out on the edge. Bake now to OKK. Pass taken away with the steal, Reeser. Reeser gets the steal, and the Pioneers a chance to grab a lead here.
Too many hands in that key to throw that pass.
Reeser around a screen, floater to the basket, is off the glass and out, no good. That one's going to be knocked out of bounds. Tech ball. So the Digs will go the other way. So Montana Tech will sub here as Caleb Belich will go out. Michael Ure is in. So OKK, Ure, Aza Williams. Also Cam Lawrence and Keely Bake. Bake across midcourt, drifting right. Pass goes left to OKK. OKK at the elbow, passes into the corner. Lawrence for three. Cam Lawrence knocks it home. So Lawrence knocks down the three. Tech goes up by four. Wayland Baptist's Hill moves it out right side, gets it into the hands of Tong. Tong leaves it for Coleman. Coleman lost the dribble out of bounds. Tech basketball. Good defense. Michael Ure out there on the wing.
Too much dribble in the corner, had nowhere to go. And that last play on the three by Lawrence was created by Okiki. They're not coming out and guarding him, so he attacked the middle guy and pulled the forward over to give Lawrence a shot from the corner.
OKK leaves it off, and here comes Keely Bake into the offensive zone. Far left, up to Lawrence. Lawrence fires, front of the rim, no good. Defensive rebound by Wayland Baptist. Here we come the other way, the Pioneers. Great move, driving the lane. Shot goes up, no good. Tipped out, Keely Bake with it. I'm not going to lie, I was expecting a cacophony of sirens. And the other way, OKK is going to get the whistle and the foul. I'm still shocked we didn't get a foul on that last when we were on the other side of the floor, to be completely honest.
Yeah, I was surprised there wasn't a call there either.
So OKK at the line. Fanya OKK has 2 points on the day. He'll shoot a pair. He's a good free throw shooter at 77%, and I opened my mouth.
You so the first one rims way out. Of doing that.
Isn't that amazing? OKK gets ready for his second.
I'd like to see him be a little more athletic going to the hoop. It really made a difference the last time down the floor.
OKK's second goes long, battled for the rebound, and coming out with it is Coleman. Coleman across midcourt gets it back. Coach readjusts him as they come into the offensive zone. I've been impressed with Coach Gallion here for Wayland Baptist today. directs traffic really well. What a move by Coleman. Reverse shot, no good. OKK with a rebound.
The move gets a 9, the shot gets a 0. That's
Aza, coast to coast, wraparound, comes out to Keely Bake. Bake up top, Michael Yore to OKK. OKK drives and draws the foul.
I like that. I like that penetration.
Like you said earlier, they're not getting to him at the arc, so he has the ability to just take off and go to the rack.
There's nobody in front of him. They're all 10 feet away from him.
And if you give him any kind of momentum, he's going to hurt you.
Yeah, and he's a great teammate. He can find you if you're open on the drive.
Reeser gets the personal foul. They'll lob it into OKK. Now to Belich. Sets the screen. Belich moves it here on the right side to Michael Yore. Back to Belich. Belly looking to his left. Spins into the high post. Leaves it off. Driving through the paint. Great pass to Lawrence, and it will roll in. OKK tips it in. Six-point lead for the Digs, 50-44. Wayland Baptist up top, driving his hill. Hill to the basket, no good. Hits the iron, and Michael Yore gets the rebound, jump ball.
Yeah, that's and a correct call. Michael's confused, but they both had a hold of it.
And that will be Montana Tech basketball. 12:23 left to play here in this ball game. Montana Tech leading 50-44. So Hill will get a breather here for Wayland. We do this all the time. We talk about players we would never take off the floor. Taji Hill is one that would never see the bench even for a breather for me.
I agree.
OKK. Drips down to the bottom left corner, comes out to Belich. Now Keely Bake. Montana Tech leads by 6, their biggest lead of the second half. Cam Lawrence around a screen. Bounce pass to OKK. He'll fire from 14, and he gets it.
That's his range. Got his range again. He's not being guarded. He can hurt him. There's your first little eight-point run.
So the lead is 8. Wayland needing some points here. Montana Tech shooting 58% here in the second half. Wayland at 36% in this second half. They'll lob it into the big man, and Belfield puts it home.
No backside help. There's nothing you can do about that.
He is a monster.
He is. He does a good job of holding off while he gets the ball over the top.
Yeah, good hands, good feet. Like he, you know, his size is one thing, but he certainly brings a lot more to the plate.
Only thing he doesn't have is an outside game.
Belich down in the corner, Cam Lawrence. Lawrence with the left hand drives, gets tripped up, goes to the ground hard. And here comes Wayland back the other way. Losing the dribble is Coleman. To the baseline. Nice take to the rack. Whistle and a foul. Murray gets the basket. And he will go to the line shooting 1. Personal foul to Belich. That's only his first. So Wayland Baptist decides to shut down the Montana Tech run. Get a little momentum themselves. 11:09 left to play here in this ball game at the line. Michael Murray. So Murray at the stripe, shooting 1. Free throw is on its way and good. So Michael Murray has 9 points. And the lead is cut to 3 for Montana Tech, 52-49. 9 minutes gone here in this second half. Dribbling right, pass in the corner to Aza Williams. That one's knocked out of his hands. Ortiger basketball in their offensive zone. 10:56 remaining here in the ball game. The Digs leading 52-49. Caleb Belich will look to inbound. Comes out to Keely Bake.
Time for Asian Gray. He's been real quiet.
A down inside to Belich, and Belich hammers it home. So the Digs by 5. Quinton Coleman across the timeline. Coleman spins to his left through the lane. Coleman attacks. That one rolls out no good. And the rebound controlled Keely Bake. Bake down the floor. 3-on-2 across to Decons. Out to Aza Williams. Williams for 3. No good. Decons tips it. And we're going to get a whistle and a foul on the rebound. And that's going to go against Brett Leach as Belich went sliding across the floor as he got shoved.
Non-contact sport.
Yeah, you know,
he must have tripped.
10:23 left to play in the ball game. Personal foul goes to Leach. That's his third.
He hurt his shoulder too. He's got to come out.
Yeah, he's flexing it pretty hard. He'll stay in the ball game. DeMichael Belfield will check back in, as does Taji Hill. And the Digs will look to inbound here. Krishan Dixon looking for somewhere to go. Bounce pass to Belich. Belich turns, fires, no good. Defensive rebound by Jones. Jones to Hill. Here comes Hill across the timeline. Tech by five. Hill attacks, ball taken away. Krishan Dixon going to be called to the foul.
Yeah, I thought he got it originally when he started his penetration. Late whistle.
10-10 left to play here in the ball game. And looking to bring it in. They'll lob it into the hands of Jones. Jones with a ball fake through the lane. Shot is up and long. And Asa Williams is going to pick up the personal. So Asa gets his first personal foul. That's team foul number four on the Digs. So that will stack up the key. And Javonte Jones will go to the stripe.
Got Asa for two up there.
Oh. And as we all know, I can't even count to five to keep track of fouls.
I know you like to keep track, so I'm trying to help you out here.
And at the stripe, Jones' first is good. He has 3 points today. And Jones will get the ball for his second attempt here. 4-point lead for the Digs, 54-50. Jones. The place gets nice and loud for him. His second is off the iron, no good. Belich with a rebound. Rebound number three on the day for Belich. Montana Tech leads by four into the offensive side. Asa Williams. Asa has a lane, and he will be fouled as Javonte Jones got a hip on him. And we're going to get a timeout. 9:55 remaining here in the ball game. Montana Tech leading 54-50 with the timeout on the court. We'll take one. We're back right after this.
We really wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything, really. The personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
I think there's more than one thing that makes Montana Tech unique.
I think it's incredible. It's just, it's special.
I've always kind of thrived off the adventure side of things, the unknown. There's no place I'd rather be going to school. Montana Tech has provided me more than I ever could have expected.
Montana Tech made me a trailblazer.
Montana Tech made me a healer.
Montana Tech is my solution.
Be the solution. Visit Montana Tech today.
54-50, Montana Tech leading by four. As we are basically at the midway point here of the second half, Montana Tech shooting 48% for the game, 53% here in the second half. On the other side, Wayland shooting 36% for the game, 42% here in this second half. Krishan, boy, nice take by Deacons. And Deacons gets it in the foul. What a take by Hayden Deacons. Hello.
Speaking of athleticism,
great move. Hayden Deacons with 6 points. Personal foul charge to Reeser is third. And Deacons will shoot one. 6-point lead for the Digs. Make it seven. That's their biggest lead here in the second half. They had a 9-point lead in the first. 7-point lead now here in the second. Wayland across midcourt. Hill moves it out on the right side to Reeser. Reeser wanting to pass on the interior, feeds it down on the block to Belfield. Belfield draws the double team. Shot blocked by Deacons. Asa Williams across to Belich. Belich to the glass. Counted the foul, Caleb Belich.
There's your run. That's two.
How about Hayden Deacons on both sides of the floor?
Everything about that was beautiful. Great pass to Bellage. Asa gave it up.
Matching their biggest lead of the game, Montana Tech goes up 59-50. And Caleb Bellage at the line, shooting one. Bellage, the senior out of Manhattan. He's an 87% free throw shooter. And his lone free throw is up and good. I'm pretty sure that between everyone here for Caleb Bellage and everyone here for Keeley Bake, the towns of Fairfield and Manhattan, Montana, are empty.
Yeah, nice time to be a burglar.
don't say that.
Well, it's true.
Don't say that.
That's a joke.
Belfield to Hill. Nice take by Michael Ure. Bounce pass, Krishan Dixon. Dixon shot blocked. Wow, what a play. What a play by Taji Hill. Hill blocked that shot, then threw it off the foot of the Montana Tech player. That is Wayland Baptist basketball because of Taji Hill. That was a phenomenal play on the defensive side.
That was a phenomenal play.
Tech by 10. 60-50, the digs up over Wayland Baptist. Baptist with the basketball. Coleman into the offensive zone, moves it across to Reeser. Reeser. He'll get it off there to Coleman. Coleman around a screen, makes his way to the basket, and he is going to go to the foul line.
They got him.
8:44 left to play here in the ball game. Good sportsmanship on both sides there. As Asa Williams fell across him, and the two chatted there briefly. And normally when we say chatted, normally we're talking about the work, but they were actually chatting, making sure each other are okay.
They're good. This game's physical, but these are two good sportsmanlike teams. And this guy, you want to tell him he's small or grunt? Me to tell him.
Well, I'll tell you, Coleman's had himself a ball game.
This kid can play.
He's the deal, man. He has 11 points, all those in the first half. And that is his first point here in the second half. So at the line, Coleman will shoot one more. And he will get the ball for a second. Quinton Coleman averages 14 a game. He has 12 thus far. Coleman's second is up and out, no good. Huge rebound for Sean Dixon.
Yeah, well, he's been known to get up, but I didn't know he could get up that high.
That was impressive. Nice springs by Krishan. Digs the other way. Young man from Billings. Ball stripped out of his hands. Good defense, Coleman. Coleman behind the back into the offensive zone. Coleman trying to jumpstart this Wayland Baptist team. Moving to his right, throws it up top to Murray. Murray attacks, and that one comes up short. Belfield has the ball stripped out. Montana Tech gets it. Tech is doing a phenomenal job on Belfield here over the last 7 minutes. Bellich into the offensive zone, puts on the brakes. Krishan Dixon to Keeley Bake. Actually, they'll change. Coach calls out the offense.
Wants to play.
Dribbling right, Krishan Dixon. Up top to Bellage. Bellage steps through. Bellage right to the rack. Hello. Caleb Bellage with 14.
I love it when coaches want something and it works. Nice job by Bellage.
An 11-point lead for the Digs. Just a phenomenal story for Caleb Bellage, the senior out of Manhattan. Last year in the first round game here in Butte, he blew his knee in a bad way in the first minute of that playoff game. He worked his tail off to get through rehab, through surgery. He got back basically in December. He was the Frontier Conference MVP from a year ago, and he's first team all-conference this year, again, after destroying his knee and working like a madman to get back on the floor for the Digs.
A lot to be proud of, and his family really supported him. That was big.
Big time. Belfield gets the inbound, and he will get the foul. As Okeke will be called to the hold. The team foul number 7 on the Digs.
That's a power matchup there, and Okeke just did not have the physical strength. In fact, if anybody could come out here and try to guard this guy, it'd be Deedon or Lawrence, because they're stronger.
So Belfield at the line. He averages 13 a game. He sits at 13 points. Belfield. He has a double-double, knocks down the front half of the bonus. 14 points for DeMichael Belfield. And John Thatcher is just in love with this kid.
I am. This guy's got a lot of tools.
He is your M.O., man.
He is my M.O.
His second back of the rim, no good. Montana Tech grabs the rebound. DeMichael Belfield has 14 points, 11 rebounds. And Tech into the offensive zone. 10 turnovers, Wayland Baptist, 8 for Montana Tech. Into the high post, they go to Okeke. Back out, Keely Bake. Bounce pass in the corner. Nice feed into Okeke. His shot blocked. Belfield got a piece of it. And here we go the other way for the Pioneers. Quickly down the floor, Keely Bake dives for it. What a play by Keely Bake, ladies and gentlemen.
Smartest IQ guy on the floor.
10-point lead for the Digs. That's one of those plays that won't show up on any stat, but that's what he brings to this team.
That shows you how smart he is.
Deacon's in the paint, spins to his left, puts it up off balance, no good. Great job by Okeke to throw it out. Montana Tech remains in possession. That was a great play. Cross court, Lawrence, ball fake. Backdoor cut, Rashawn Dixon back to Lawrence. Left side, Keely Bake. Steps inside, Bake drives, puts it up. Keely Bake, ladies and gentlemen. Keely Bake has 9, the Digs by a dozen. Driving the other way, ball comes out, Tech basketball.
There's your big run.
That's it. Tech right now in control, and Wayland Baptist going to call a timeout. And they needed that timeout.
6-14.
About 4 points ago.
Tell you,
they waited
place,
too long to call it.
This place is electric right now. We have a full timeout, so we'll take one. Montana Tech leads by 12. We're back after this.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then Gain Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. NAIA National Tournament action here on Digger Vision. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher. I have to say, I've talked to a plethora of people on the phones this week selling tickets, and I have had some great conversations with Texas families coming up. So I just want to say hi, and again, like truly, we've had some really good conversations about Montana, about coming up here, and it was a real treat to talk to some of the families.
Yeah, you got to like that.
6:14 left to play here in the ball game. Montana Tech up by 12, their biggest lead of the game. Tech shooting 55% here in the second half. And the Pioneers coming with 1-2-2 full court pressure here. Trap is looking to make it happen. Here they come. Rashawn Dixon dribbles through, passes out to Lawrence. Lawrence, great feed into Okeke, and he is fouled.
Let me help you out with the press. It is hard to press great guards. It's not going to happen here tonight. If they don't want trap immediately, they're not going to get a trap at midcourt.
Well,
it is hard.
And the other side for me, now we're going to get a player foul out. Brett Leach is going to foul out of the ball game. So Brett will foul out of the ball game. So Leach, who ran into foul trouble early, will foul out of the ball game here for Wayland Baptist. That will bring Belfield back in.
Here comes my man, Belfield.
The other one I was going to say with the trap is we continually talk about the fact that all these teams are coming up to our, you know, nearly 6,000-foot elevation. And if you're going to put that kind of effort in trapping, that is going to really drain the gas tank quickly.
Well, you know, they didn't do any of it the first half, so it didn't. But they're playing hard enough, it should be bothering them. It's, with 6 minutes to go, it's not going to bother them.
OKK's first rolls in. So he will get ready to shoot one more. Ifanye Okeke here for Montana Tech. His second money. 8 points on the day for Ifanye Okeke. And across the timeline comes Coleman. Coleman gets rid of it. And a block call on Hayden Deacons.
Correct call. He doesn't like it, but that was the correct call. He got his chest on him. He wasn't in front of him.
So that will put Tong at the line. So Tom will go to the stripe here for the Pioneers. And again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. As Tong at the line, checking out Krishan Dixon. He's had a tremendous second half for Montana Tech.
He hasn't made many mistakes tonight. He's doing what he spoke to us, lead this team, and he's done it.
Tong, free throw attempt, no good. Keely Bake with a rebound. Montana Tech by 14.
I certainly hope Keely Blake wasn't down on the bottom block balking out. I almost died when he got that rebound. So where'd you come from?
OKK. The Lawrence. Lawrence top of the horn moves it out to Belich. Belich fires that one off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound controlled by the Pioneers the other way. They're shooting 35% here in the second half. Far right wing with it. Coleman. Coleman. Boy, he is just lightning quick. What a take by Coleman.
He is a smart basketball player.
He is fun to watch, boy.
He backed that out of there and blew by everybody.
Quentin Coleman has 14 points. He has hit his average on the season. Montana Tech with it. OKK left side, Aza Williams. Williams feeds it to OKK, rifles it out. Keely Bake, three-point shot, rattles out. And Wayland finally gets to that rebound. We're back the other way. 4:50 left to play here in this ball game. Coleman steps back. I'm honestly kind of surprised that Hill isn't on the floor here for Wayland as well. And that's going to be a travel call as falling to the ground is Tong, and then he slid. And that's going to be a timeout here on the floor. 4:39 left to play here in the ball game. Montana Tech leading 66-54. We have a full timeout. We'll take one. We're back right after this.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Welcome back here once again as Montana Tech leading 66-54. Frontier Conference champions, Frontier Conference tournament champions, the Ordiggers, number 8 in the country, taking on Wayland Baptist, the Pioneers. Phenomenal basketball team. 21-9 on the year, 15-7 in the Sooner Athletic Conference. And full court pressure again here. Looks like full court man. We'll see if Keely Bake rifles it into Lawrence. Lawrence across to Michael Yore, jump stop. Yore spins in traffic, turns, whistle, and a foul. Late whistle, but Michael Yore is going to go to the stripe. .430 left to play.
That was an interesting call because the guard thought he blocked the ball, and I think Yore did too. He turned around, held his mouth like I missed that little shot over that little guy, and he got the call.
Michael Yore at the free throw line. First is up and out, no good.
I love the reaction of players.
I agree.
I love it.
Free throw line.
Except when they whine and they don't have a right to. It's like, I never touch him. Oh, he's bleeding. So, yeah, you did touch him.
The free throw line continues to not be the friend of Montana Tech right now. Michael Yore gets one of two. He has 4 points on the day. Boy, he has battled, but he has been in a brawl with a big man here today. Through the lane, right to the rack. Shot is up and out, no good. Offensive rebound by Wayland. Driving Pioneers with a right hand. Great take by Michael Murray.
That's his move right there.
I'll tell you, boy, he is powerful going to the basket. If you give him a little bit of a lane, he is going to gouge you. Far left side, Montana Tech with the ball. Pass comes out to Keely Bake. Belich comes out. 4 minutes left to play here in the ball game. Tech leads by 11. Backdoor cut. Asa Williams. What a pass. What a finish.
I think he almost hit his head.
14 points for Asa Williams. That's his first basket of the second half. Tech leads by 13. Wayland Baptist, far right wing, Coleman. Coleman drives, stops. Count it, the foul. I've run out of adjectives for this kid.
That's as good a guard as you'll find in the NAIA basketball right there.
Man, he is fun.
He is good. He is quick, great ball handler, has floor vision, and can score.
And smart.
The only problem he's got on this team, he can't rebound as much as the big guys. That's his only downfall.
Quentin Coleman at the line. He's 3 of 4. Front half of the bonus, or the one, excuse me, he has 16 points, my apologies. And now that makes it 17 for Coleman. 10-point lead for the Digs. Pass Asa Williams down to Belich. Belich far left wing, backs it out to Asa Williams.
Smart basketball. Pull it out, run some clock, run your stuff.
Michael Ewer out near midcourt. Throws it on the right side, Cam Lawrence. Lawrence hands it off to Belich. Belich around a screen. Belich stops at the arc, comes up top to Ewer, now to Asa Williams. Williams, a little switch dribble, has a lane. Boy, that's going to be offensive.
Yep, absolutely.
Boy, standing his ground on the inside that time was Coleman. Coleman put the roots down, and he was not moving.
That's the second charge he's drawn tonight.
Asa picks up his fourth personal.
If you remember correctly, the first one was a collision. Yeah.
3:07 left to play in the ball game. Montana Tech by 10, and the Digs will call a timeout. We have had one player foul out, and we have multiple with four personals. As for Wayland, Leach fouled out, but then Coleman has four personal fouls. On the other side for Montana Tech, Asa Williams has four personals, and Deacons has four personals. Both of those kind of rare, honestly, especially Asa. It doesn't feel like Asa gets too deep into foul trouble very often.
Well, you know, it's always about matchups. And yep, if you got one quicker or you make some mistakes, it's easy to have. But you know what? Fouls don't matter now. This is over. I think mentally Wayland has kind of thrown in the towel. I'm just watching their faces, and I'm watching the coaches. And yeah, they're still having a little enthusiasm, but that's a tough boat. Oh, they're only down 10. I thought, yep, they were down more than that.
We're down 10, baby. We're almost there. You get this possession. Wayland's got the ball. You pull this to single digits.
What gym am I in? I thought they were down 16.
You were imagining a world where you were still coaching and you had Quentin Coleman as your guard and you had Belfield down at the block.
That would work for me.
So a chance to bring this to single digits here. 3:07 left to play in this ball game. I'm not sure what we're waiting for here. There we go. The inbound to Hill. He's been very quiet in this, especially the last 10 minutes or so. Coleman, on the other hand, has not been. Coleman moves it across to Hill. Hill, bounce pass comes up top to Murray. Murray here on the near wing. Wayland four wide, around a screen. Coleman. Coleman, pass into the deep corner. Hill. Hill, baseline take, no. Second tip, no. Third tip is up and in. That one knocked in by Carson.
Now we're going to have pressure on both ends of the court.
2:35 left to play here in the ball game. Montana Tech leads by 8. As they will spread the floor here. OKK looking left, hands it off to Cam Lawrence. Lawrence steps back. Shot clock is down to 10. Lawrence lobs it in. Belich. Belich spins to his left. Shot swatted, but a whistle and a foul. That's going to go on Belfield. So Belfield will pick up his third personal.
Tough guys get up after a foul like that. That drove him right to the ground.
Yes. So at the line, Caleb Belich. He's an 87% free throw shooter. The Digs lead by 8. That one hits the iron, bounces out, no good. Boy, again, Montana Tech, 55% from the foul line right now. Substitution, Michael Ewer is in. Hayden Deacons getting ready to come in. Again, remember, Deacons has four personals. Cam Lawrence will go out. Ewer and Deacons in the key. Belich at the line. And out there as well for the Digs, Asa Williams at midcourt. Krishan Dixon just outside the arc. Belich's second is short. 8-point lead for the Digs. Wayland into the offensive zone. Pioneers wide left. Pioneers driving as Coleman pull-up jumper, no good. Rebound tipped. Montana Tech comes out with it. Asa Williams slams it home.
High percentage shot, did I ever tell you?
Yeah, a little bit. 10-point lead for the Digs. Pioneers with it. Hill right to the racket. He gets it. This guard tandem is just phenomenal.
This guard play all over the court is phenomenal.
Asa Williams, far right side. They'll play keep away here for a minute. Montana Tech leading by 8. Bounce pass to Michael Uhr. 90 seconds remaining. Shot clock trickles down to 12. Now 10.
Going to the hoop.
Krishan Dixon wide left. Shot clock at 6. Krishan up top to Uhr. Right side, Asa Williams. 3 seconds. Asa switches, fires. Asa Williams, front of the rim, no good. Rebound out of bounds. And they'll say Wayland basketball. 1:09 left to play. An 8-point lead for the Digs. Okeke will come in. Belich will go out. Deedon will come in. Michael Uhr will go out. So we'll get adjustments for defense and offense here for the Digs.
They got to pick that paper up off the floor down there. Somebody can get hurt bad on that.
1:07 left to play in the ball game. Down the floor, Coleman.
Big
step
shot.
Step back. 3-ball. No. Long rebound controlled by Murray. Murray attacks, gets it. Michael Murray has 13 points and a quick timeout. Montana Tech leads by 6. 71-65, a short timeout with under a minute left to play here in this ball game. Can we just play like another couple halves with these two teams?
It'd be awesome. That would be special. I don't think they'd vote for that because they're a little bit tired. You and I are for it because we're watching it.
I know the Sooner Athletic Conference isn't going to like this, but as a representative of the Frontier Conference, Arizona Christian just recently joined us as a football member. Maybe, just maybe, Wayland Baptist would have a nice home in the Frontier Conference for basketball. You know, it's just a little travel. Boy, it's just a little trip.
It's not like this conference isn't tough enough as it is. Now you're bringing in another dagger. This is...
Love it.
This is good. Oh, I love it too.
A 6-point lead for the Digs. They will inbound. Wayland has 3 guys in the backcourt.
Got all their free throw shooters in.
Krishan Dixon will look to bring it in. They'll get separation down the floor to Asa Williams. Williams drops it off to Belich. Belich holds on to it. Belich now to Keeley Bake. 50 seconds remaining. Bake going right. Bake. Double team, still playing keep away. Moves it around. Uhr down to the bottom left corner. Asa Williams, he's fouled. Boy, a lot of time comes off the clock.
When you're chasing the ball, it always does. They probably should have fouled. I don't know who you foul.
I truly
mean, make a choice. Make a choice. They've got a scouting report over there. Make a choice. Got to know.
42 seconds remaining. Montana Tech leading 71-65. The winner of this one will take on the Warriors of Lewis Clark State tomorrow at 6. Free throw, Asa Williams, good. Asa Williams, 17 points.
Monster free throw. That makes 3 trips down the floor.
Montana Tech will sub in the defensive boys again.
What Montana Tech does not want to do is foul to stop this clock.
Yeah. Williams the line for number 2. He has 17 points here today. He averages 16 a game. Again, he had 31 in the conference championship. And the second one rattles in good. Asa Williams, 18 points.
There comes our man going to the hoop.
Down the floor, Coleman. Coleman, stutter step behind the back. Coleman attacks.
No other place for him to go. Get it there. Great ball handler.
The kid's like a video game, isn't he?
He is a video game. He is, Tech's 2 guards are quick. He just is blown by everybody, and he's great through the legs, behind the back. He just got it. Has a feel for where the basket is, draws the foul. That's a great guard.
Quentin Coleman is having an outstanding ball game. He has 17 points. Chance to tie Asa Williams as the leading scorer, and he does so. Coleman has 18. Asa Williams has 18. Montana Tech will sub out the offensive guys again. Belich, Uhr will both come in. Keely Bake, Krishan Dixon, Asa Williams stay out. Obviously, as you mentioned earlier, all the free throw shooters. Diggs leading 73-66. The second is money. Quinton Coleman has 19.
Back to a two-possession game. They're going to have to foul quickly, though, if they get it in bounds here, which they should, running the 1-4. Yeah, there you go.
Michael Ure gets the inbound, bobbled, fouled. Yeah, as Rodney Carson was there, also Michael Murray was there. And I believe Murray is going to get it, and that's the case.
The pressure is off when you only got to make one out of two. And that's exactly all he's got to do here.
Michael Ure at the line, a 71% free throw shooter on the year. Mike is 2 of 4 from the stripe today. And Mike gets the ball for attempt number one. 32 seconds remaining here in the first, in this ball game rather. First round matchup, Michael Ure's first is money. 5 points for Mike. Montana Tech leads by 7.
Now why are they substituting?
Defense.
Rebounding.
There you go.
Want the rebounders in there. God, I'm going to become a coach someday.
You think maybe?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to work on this. I mean, I go back and get a degree.
Anybody who knows you is not going to allow that to happen. Michael, your second is good.
Anybody that's ever played for me does not want that to happen.
Montana Tech leads 75-67 with 32 seconds left to play here in the ball game. It looks like a short timeout. We'll go ahead and keep it here. Thanks for joining us. Round one of this NAIA National Tournament. The winner will take on Lewis Clark State tomorrow at 6 p.m. And, boy, we have had some fun here tonight. Thanks for joining us on Bigger Vision. Paul Benisco, John Thatcher. I do believe after the ball game, we'll try and track down Coach Adam Hyatt.
Good idea. Don't jinx him. Don't even bring up winning tomorrow. I'm just telling you.
I'm not going there. Come on, man.
All the times I've never talked to you. All the times you tried to interview me, and I ignore you so you wouldn't jinx my team.
There were a lot of times that you wouldn't talk to me. Yeah.
You never asked me to talk to you. Killing me.
You'd always swear at me and make hand gestures. Down the floor, Coleman. Coleman quickly into the zone. He's going to fire. That one goes long. Rebound battled for. Jump ball. And Wayland Baptist will have the possession arrow. There isn't anything better than tournament basketball. But this is just the best.
Well, you bring your A-plus game. It isn't even, I mean, during the season, you have all kinds of ups and downs, but you better be coming to these to play if you want to get to that magical championship.
Oh, they're going to, well, but did they change time? Shot clock, maybe? I thought he made a signal at the bench. I'm not sure what it was.
I thought he signaled 11.
I did, too. Three-point shot is up, no good. Offensive rebound, up and out, no good. Deacons is going to foul out.
Dangerous.
Deacons is going to foul out, and going to the line is going to be Jones. So Jones will shoot 2. Oh, only 4. Well, they didn't call it on Deacons. They called the foul on OKK. I'm sorry. I thought so. OKK picks up his 4th.
Doesn't matter. This is free throw shooter's substitution.
Yep. 19 seconds remaining, and at the foul line going to be Jones. Montana Tech leads 75-67. Packed house here on a Friday. Thanks for joining us.
That was a real critical miss right there. You had to get within 2 possessions.
Jones' 2nd is up and out, no good. Offensive rebound stripped away. Krishan Dixon. Keely Bake into the offensive zone. Bake playing keep away. He'll slalom into the paint, moves it back out to Krishan, and this one's going to the record books. Montana Tech is going to get the win, 75-67. The Ortigers will take down the Pioneers, and they will advance into the second round of the NAIA Men's National Championship Tournament.
And it was not an easy task. They put a great team out of Wayland Baptist, and it's just a great basketball game.
75-67, our final. Let's take a quick timeout. We'll come back. We'll give you the numbers. We'll wrap up our podcast, ladies and gentlemen. We'll take a break. We're back right after this.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Triton 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then Aim Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech as they get the bracket up. The Ordiggers moved their logo onto the second round. Just a phenomenal ball game. You know, the Warriors were waiting to find out who won this one. Montana Tech gets the win, 75-67. JT, give us your final thoughts here before we get into the numbers.
Just a well-played basketball team, two great teams. One shooting control this game, the scoring, I didn't expect it to be over 70, so I guess right once for something. But both teams played really well. Just Tech shot the ball a lot better, and I thought in critical situations, they knocked their free throws down when earlier in the game they weren't knocking their free throws down. So,
you know, we talked about it in the pregame, the idea that Montana Tech, one of the best defensive teams in the country, only allowing 65 points a game. Wayland Baptist just barely gets their nose above that mark.
That's good defense, Paul.
Thank you for that insight,
my
friend.
That's all I got to say. That is good defense.
Let's take a look at the individual numbers here. We'll start things off. Yeah, let's see. Are we moving? Coach is moving this way. Let me go see if we can. Let's do this. Let's take a quick timeout, and we will see if we can track down Coach Hyatt, and then we'll get you the numbers, and we will put this thing into the record books here in just a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Give me a moment. We'll see if we can get Coach Hyatt, and we're back right after this.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel. I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Well, let's wrap this thing up here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's run through the scoring here as they're starting to take down the cameras. We'll start things off for the Pioneers out of Wayland Baptist. Just a phenomenal ball game. The Pioneers will finish their season at 21-10 overall. Just an outstanding ball game here. They were led by Quentin Coleman with 19 points. Murray gets 13. Belfield with 14 points and 11 rebounds. So double-double for Belfield.
That is a big game.
And the other side of that is it's big for Montana Tech. He had 8 rebounds at the half, and he only had 3 in the second half.
It didn't seem like he played as much in the second half.
Yeah, it wasn't
the factor. They were rotating 3 of them, and he didn't play as much.
Looks like Taji Hill will get a dozen here tonight, a pair of 3-pointers, kind of highlighting that. Rodney Carson Jr. with 4. Boltong with 2 points on the night for Wayland Baptist here on a Friday night. On the other side for Montana Tech, leading scorer Aza Williams. Aza gets 18 points here today, 12 in the first half, 6 in the second half, 2 of 2 from the foul line, 2 3-pointers as well. Caleb Belich with 14 points. Belly had 1 3-pointer, the rest of his damage coming in the paint here this evening. Michael Yor will get 6 points. Cam Lawrence with 5. Rashawn Dixon with 4. Bridger Deedon with 4. Ifanye Okeke, 8 points for Okeke. And he came to roll here tonight.
He did. You know, I was not happy with him not penetrating when they were giving it to him. And when he did that, it started expanding the lead. He made a couple great passes, made a couple buckets. Real critical. He's got to score.
This game's about scoring. I don't care how many shots you can block or score.
Keely Bake with 9 points. Hayden DeConce gets 7 on the night. Michael Yore once again with 6 points for the Yore Diggers out of Montana Tech. So the first round behind us as the Warriors won the opener over Hope International. That sets up our second round matchup between the Warriors of Lewis-Clark State and Montana Tech tomorrow night at 6 p.m. And, of course, you can watch that here on Digger Vision. Once again, our final 75-67. The Digs take down Wayland Baptist here on Digger Vision for Jonathan. I'm Paul Panisco. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you tomorrow night. Till then, take care.